Telomeres. You've probably seen supplements that claim to make them longer, but I'm not buying it. And today, I'm going to break down exactly why. Now, I first heard this from Dr. Bill Andrews at RadFest, the one that I just attended in Las Vegas, and it stopped me cold. If you don't know who he is, Andrews is one of the top researchers on telomere and aging. Back in the 90s, he led the team at Geron Corporation that discovered the human genes responsible for producing telomerase. Telomerase is the enzyme that lengthens telomeres. And he's been chasing ways to safely activate it ever since. Now, his message at RadFest was simple. The only thing that can actually lengthen your telomeres is telomerase. And most supplements out there, they either don't activate it at all, or they don't activate it nearly enough to matter. Now, in this video, I'm going to break down what telomeres are, what telomerase does, and why most products claiming to support telomeres aren't telling you the full story. I'll show you the tricks companies use to make it look like your telomeres are getting longer, even when they're not. And I'll walk you through what actually slows the loss of telomeres and what might move the needle even though it's not a magic fix. By the way, my name is Hitch. I've reversed my biological age by a couple of decades, and investigating longevity is what I do all day, every day. Okay, so you probably heard that telomeres are one of the keys to aging, and that the shorter your telomeres are, the older your cells are. And that's true up to a point. But let's actually break down what telomeres are, why they shrink, and what that means for how long you can live. Telomeres are like little caps at the ends of your chromosomes. They're non-coding strands of DNA, and their job is to protect your DNA from getting eroded. Every time a cell divides, those caps get shorter. And it's not so much that they get shorter, it's just that not all of them get replicated. Less and less gets replicated each time your cell divides. Eventually, they get too short. And when that happens, the cells can't divide anymore. It either goes into senescence or dies off completely. That's aging at the cellular level. Now, there's an analogy that Dr. Bill Andrews used, and I kind of like it. Think of the struggle to lengthen telomeres as a tug of war. On one side, you've got everything that shortens your telomeres. Inflammation, oxidative stress, smoking, obesity, low levels of vitamin D or omega-3s, chronic stress, depression, pessimism, and of course, cell division. That's the main one. What's on the other side trying to lengthen those telomeres? Just one thing, telomerase. That's it. Telomerase is the only thing that will lengthen telomeres. And in almost every cell in your body, telomerase is turned off. So the shortening side of the tug of war is always winning. Now, even if you clean up your lifestyle, eat clean, meditate, exercise, whatever, you're still dealing with something called end replication problem. That's the built-in, unavoidable shortening that happens every time DNA is copied during cell division, no matter what. And that's what leads to the basal level of telomere shortening, the floor that you can't drop below. This rate of shortening sets the theoretical maximum human lifespan at around 125 years. Because when telomeres get too short, your DNA starts to erode. And that's usually at around 50 to 75 cell divisions. That's what's called the Haylick limit. Now, you can slow telomere shortening down, but you can't stop it. And unless you're turning on telomerase, your telomeres aren't getting any longer. Okay, like I said, there's only one thing that can actually make your telomeres grow longer. Just one, and that's telomerase. Telomerase is an enzyme. And what it does is pretty simple. It adds back this repeating, non-coding DNA sequence to the ends of your telomeres. That's how telomeres get longer. So where is telomerase actually active in the human body? It's active in germ cells, your sperm and egg-producing cells. It's active in some stem cells, the ones that replenish tissues, and it's very active in cancer cells, which is why they continue to divide forever. And that's why most cancer cells are considered to be immortal cells. But in your regular somatic cells, the ones that make up most of your body, telomerase is turned off. Why? Because keeping it on would let damaged cells divide forever, and that's called cancer. So your body makes a trade-off. Lose some telomere length with every division and accept aging, or risk immortal cells turning cancerous. So telomerase gets locked down, shut off in most of our cells. And here's the big takeaway. If you're not turning on your telomerase in your somatic cells, you're not lengthening your telomeres. Okay, so here's where we stand. You've got this tug of war going on in your cells. On one side, you've got all these factors that are shortening your telomeres. On the other side, just telomerase, if it's turned on, but it's not. So your telomeres are getting shorter. What can you do? Well, how about supplements that can lengthen your telomeres? Yeah, not so fast, Abernathy. Typically, when the supplement company wants to demonstrate that something has lengthened telomeres, here's what they do. First, they do a blood test that measures telomere length to set a baseline. Then, after taking the supplement for a certain period of time, they'll do another test. And the second test will show a longer average telomere length. Sounds good, right? But here's what they don't tell you. Those tests don't measure individual telomeres. In your blood sample, you've got cells with short telomeres, with medium telomeres, and with long telomeres. So in the blood sample, the result that you get back is just an average of the telomere length across all the cells in the sample. And here's the trick. You can change the average without lengthening a single telomere. Now, let me break this down. Some compounds are cytotoxic. They kill off damaged or senescent cells. And guess which cells are the most susceptible to these toxins? Right, the ones with the shortest telomeres. So when a lot of these cells with shorter telomeres die off, the average telomere length in your sample goes up. The average gets longer. But did any telomeres actually grow in length? Nope. Other compounds or interventions can be immunogenic. They trigger your body to release new immune cells from the bone marrow. These naive cells haven't divided much, so they have naturally longer telomeres. What happens when you dump a bunch of these cells into your blood with longer telomeres? The average telomere length gets longer, but still, no telomere lengthening occurred, just a shift in the population. Now, you can do all of this without activating telomerase. And we know that telomerase is the only thing that lengthens telomeres. So the question you need to ask is this: does the supplement that you're taking actually activate telomerase? And if so, by how much? Now, a lot of companies do use compounds that can actually activate telomerase. A little. But is it enough to overcome the shortening that's going on, to win the tug of war? Well, scientists already have a benchmark for that, and it's called the HeLa cell. Now, HeLa cells are immortalized cancer cells that crank out just enough telomerase to keep their telomeres the same length, division after division. They're not making them longer, they're just replacing what's lost each time the cell divides. It's the bare minimum for equilibrium, where every bit of shortening is perfectly balanced by repair. So the real question is this: does this supplement activate more telomerase than the HeLa cell line? Because if it doesn't, then it doesn't lengthen telomeres. And so far, no compound known to man can even come close to activating as much telomerase as the HeLa cell line. In fact, the only thing that can activate that much telomerase is telomerase gene therapy. Okay, so we've established that you can't lengthen telomeres, or even maintain them at the correct length, right? So what's the best you could hope for? The answer is to slow down the rate at which they're shortening. Now, some compounds have been shown to activate telomerase in human somatic cells, not at the HeLa cell level, but enough to slow shortening. And if you slow that baseline shortening, the kind that happens with a perfect lifestyle, you could, in theory, push past the 125-year limit set by the end replication problem. But Here's the catch. That only works if your lifestyle is already on track to get you to that 125-year ceiling in the first place. If you're smoking, eating garbage, never exercising, not getting enough sleep, no compound is going to magically erase that damage. These telomerase activators might buy you extra time, but only if you've already done the hard work to earn it. So what might those compounds be? Well, there's TA65 derived from astragalus, which has shown mild telomerase activation in both lab and small human studies. Another example is a compound from Andrew's own lab at Sierra Sciences. Now, it doesn't have a brand name yet. They just call it C0057684. In cell studies, it activated telomerase to about 16% of HeLa levels, higher than anything else tested publicly, but still not enough to fully stop telomere loss. Now, I want to talk about a compound that biohackers love to bring up when you talk about telomerase, Epatitalon. It's a synthetic tetrapeptide developed in Russia, and it's been studied for its effects on aging, DNA repair, and yes, telomerase activation. Some small studies, mostly in cell cultures and animals, show that Epatitalon can upregulate telomerase expression in certain human cells. Now, sounds impressive, right? But let's talk numbers, because this is where it gets tricky. Laboratory studies confirm that Epatitalon boosts telomerase activity and can extend telomeres in human cells, but no published study gives us a clear sense of how much telomerase gets activated. A study from 2003 found that Epatitalon induces telomerase activity and telomere lengthening in human fetal fibroblast cultures. Now, the treated cells surpassed the Haylick limit. They divided beyond the control group, showing that telomerase was reactivated and telomeres lengthened, but not by how much. One study from this year showed that Epatitalon could make telomeres longer in both normal and cancer cells, and it cranked up telomerase enzyme activity. But here's the catch. It didn't say how much it boosted it. No numbers, no details, just, yeah, it did something. So, yeah, we know it does something, we just don't know how much. Epatitalon's just one example of how peptides are being explored for serious longevity applications and why it's so important to understand what they actually do and how to use them correctly. That's why I created Primer on Peptides, my 8-week group coaching program. It's a deep dive into the science, protocols, preparation, delivery, sourcing, and stacks that actually move the needle. The next round kicks off in early October, but you can check it out right now. Just join my free school community, the Longevity Alliance. The link's in the description. Once you're in, hit the classroom tab, scroll to the Primer on Peptides thumbnail, and click it. You'll see everything you need to know to get on board. All right, what else? Beyond compounds, is there anything that will slow telomere loss in a real, meaningful way? Yeah, there is, but don't expect miracles. There's solid evidence that some lifestyle changes do slow down telomere shortening. Regular exercise, adequate sleep, calorie restriction or fasting, omega-3 fatty acids, vitamin D, stress reduction, a clean anti-inflammatory diet, and of course, no smoking and no heavy drinking. Now, these don't lengthen telomeres, but they reduce accelerated loss. You're taking pressure off the shortening side of that tug of war. All right, let's say that you could activate telomerase in your somatic cells. Should you? That's a much bigger question. Here's the problem. Telomerase isn't just the enzyme of youth. It's the engine of immortality for cancer cells. Over 85% of human cancer cells have reactivated telomerase. Why? Because it lets them divide forever. Telomerase is what makes cancer cells immortal. So turning telomerase back on isn't like flipping a youth switch. It's like handing your cells a loaded gun. If one of those cells gets damaged, congratulations, you just gave it infinite lives. There's a reason why your body shuts off telomerase in the first place. It's a trade-off between aging and cancer prevention. Slow decline versus exponential chaos. That's the tightrope researchers are walking right now. Yeah, telomerase is the only way to actually lengthen telomeres. But activating it safely without unleashing cancer, that's the hard part, and we're not there yet. So, where does that leave us? Telomeres are a key part of the aging process, and telomerase is the only known way to rebuild them. But right now, we don't have any compound, supplement, or protocol that can safely and reliably activate telomerase in a way that would truly extend the human lifespan. A few compounds, like Epatitalon, show promise in lab settings, but we still don't know how much they help in the real world. And many products that claim to lengthen telomeres, they're just playing with the numbers, not changing biology. So for now, the best approach is a mix of lifestyle choices that reduce inflammation, oxidative stress, and cell turnover, and interventions that may help preserve telomere length somewhat by slowing the rate of loss. Now, if you found this video helpful, give it a like, leave a comment. And if you want to keep learning and stay ahead of the science, join us in the Longevity Alliance. It's free, it's grounded, and it's where this conversation continues. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.